Sacramento. We are back at Dory Alley 2013 in San Francisco, and I am here with my friend Tony Delfino, who is a bartender at the San Francisco Eagle.
Yep.
Which, if I'm not mistaken, just reopened, what was it, in March?
Beginning of March, end of February, I'm not sure. Right around there.
How has that whole experience been trying to reopen the legacy San Francisco Eagle?
It's overall been really great. It's hard trying to get people back into the routine of coming.
Yeah.
But the people that are coming back are just really phenomenal, making it a really great, fun atmosphere again.
Because the San Francisco Eagle, I mean, around the country, San Francisco has been known as kind of the heart of the leather community
right.
for so many years. So to have this staple back in the community is pretty epic.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
So I have to say, as a bartender there, what's kind of your favorite thing? What do you enjoy the most?
I enjoy getting to go out, flirt with hot men, and leave with money instead of leaving broke.
Good man, good man. So we were having a conversation offline here a little bit ago about trying to get a resurgence in the leather community. I mean,
right.
today there's so many different avenues of kink, from sports gear and rubber and latex, and it goes on and on and on. But trying to drive home, bringing the leather community back together, what has that experience been like here in San Francisco, where it seemingly kind of started?
It's a little bit of that, and it's a little bit that I'm trying to help new leathermen avoid what I went through, where I tried getting into leather like 10 years ago and had issues where people didn't really want to accept in younger people. So trying to get that energy in has been a little bit of a challenge because people are nervous, people are on both sides.
Okay.
But it's been a really good experience. People are really forthcoming here about trying to welcome in new people. They want to make sure that people have the opportunity to find their place, you know, find where they belong in the leather community.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry.
Oh, good. It's fine. One of the things I had been doing for a little while is making leather visible in typically not leather places, which has been a really good benefit for us, where we get the opportunity to have people that might have been interested in leather come up to us in their space where they feel comfortable and not feel like they have to wander into the Eagle or wander into the Powerhouse where they may not belong.
You've done a couple of events now called Leather Bombs.
Yes.
Where you've put out invites out on Facebook
mm-hmm.
for people to get together in leather. Do you want to tell us a little bit about what that whole experience
yeah.
is?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was getting into. Is
yep.
it's we would meet at a very leather-friendly place like the Eagle or like the Edge, and meet there in gear and then go together to a non-leather venue just hang out, have drinks, have fun. And it helps people who aren't in the leather community see that we're not that different from everybody else, and helps people that were interested in us feel comfortable coming up to us, feel like it's not going
to
be a scary or
trying
experience.
To take the stigma away, basically.
Yeah, both for the people that are interested and the people that maybe think that we're something other than what maybe we really are.
So when you first started getting into the leather community about 10 years ago, mm-hmm. you were talking about making kind of the same mistakes, etc. If there was somebody brand new out there that had kind of a curiosity about the leather community or just wearing leather, what's one piece of advice you would love to give that person?
Well, I think my biggest mistake was something I learned this second time when I finally made it into the community, was there's no way to do leather halfway. You can't ease your way into it. You have to just jump into it and experience it. And then, in my experience, is that people will welcome you in once you've done that.
Fantastic. Tony, thank you so much for sitting down. Well, standing with us. We're not sitting down. We could be, though. Hanging out with us today here on Sac Pride Live at Dory Alley 2013. It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.